afternoon, Fest Flyers. My name's Caitlin, and welcome to our Thanksgiving special. Hopefully, you're as excited as I am, because I cannot wait to stuff my face with so much food. That's all for me, but now on to you, London.
While the ongoing pandemic has canceled or postponed many events, there is some annual tradition that will still take place, although with a new twist. One such event is the beloved Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Although we're used to seeing masses come together to see the grandiose balloons making their way down Thanksgiving Day Parade route, this year the celebration will be a bit different. The Macy's Thanksgiving Parade will air nationwide as a television-only event with no audience on NBC and Telemundo on Thursday, November 26th from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. in all time zones. To bring safety to the spectacle, millions nationwide will be unprecedented at the time. The annual production will be reimagined as a television-only event with no audience. This year's procession will Fargo marching down the traditional 2.5-mile route in Manhattan to avoid gathering a large crowd. While there are no parades, will be marching down the amid-sea of the cheering crowds, a number of theatrical and music performances are scheduled to participate in this year's events. While performers are subject to change, here are a few scheduled to participate. Broadway greats, Hamilton and Mean Girls, stars and performances, Jimmy Fallon and the Roots, Pentatonics, and Jordan Sparks. And of course, ending the parade with Santa Claus. For many families, the Macy's Day Parade yearly tradition as much as watching football and eating turkey. What is your Thanksgiving tradition?
What's going on, Fest Flyers? How are you doing? So I just want to let you know that next week, the week after Thanksgiving, is going to be a Spirit Week. It's going to be Ultraismo House Week. It's a week full of fun and exciting spirit days and activities. This is a great way to show your school spirit and an even greater way to show your pride in your house. So, here's Leah. Let's find out what's happening on Monday.
Have you ever heard someone say that Monday is their favorite day of the week? No? But that's going to change, because Monday is PJ Day. Make sure to show off your Grinch onesie or your Rudolph socks. Then students will participate in the virtual holiday car drive. It's an easy way to say thank you and much cheaper than buying just another coffee mug. Now on to Myleene to see what activities are happening on Tuesday.
Tuesday is a colorful day. It's blinding lights day. Wear as many colors as possible. Try to wear more colors than your Christmas tree lights. Tuesday is also a trivia day for all Turismo students. Test your holiday knowledge and you could win a first place prize of $25 on an Amazon gift card. Just email Ms. Planbeck to play. Now let's hand it off to Evelyn for Wednesday's exciting adventures.
Thank you, Myleene. Wednesday is actually going to be the exact opposite of Tuesday. Instead of wearing lots of colors, we are going to be wearing black. Black is the color of altruismo. Wednesday is also our second Among Us tournament. This tournament is for altruismo students only, and will be hosted by Student Council. Only the first 32 students to email Ms. Planbeck will be able to play. Let's check out our weather girl slides.
Hello, Fest Flyers. With all the crazy weather that has been going on these past few weeks, months, and days, we will be dressing up as Crazy Weather Day, as if it was still summer. I know we live in a desert, and it's always a little like summer, so dress as if you are going to the beach or playing at the park. Now, let's see what's happening on Friday with Lorelai.
Thank you, Celeste, and hello, Flyers. Today, you talk with Lorelai. Friday is the last day of our Spirit Week, so let's have some fun. Friday is a holiday camouflage day. Wear your ribbons and bows. Wear your wrapping paper and tree ornaments. On top of that, wear your Santa hat. In addition, we will have a holiday photograph contest. Let your creativity take over and take a photo that captures some of at-home holiday spirits. You can do anything with your photos. Edit it, Photoshop, etc. Fill out the Google form submission by Friday. November 4th at 3:30. Winners will be announced on Monday, December 7th. And we'll get an Amazon gift card, $25. Happy Thanksgiving, Faiss Flyers, and on with the rest of your news.
Thank you, Landon. Well, hello, Faiss Flyers. Welcome to a 2020 special Thanksgiving with your favorite weather reporter, Celeste. Well, as you can see, this Thanksgiving is a lot more different from last year's Thanksgiving. Nobody is really outside to enjoy the fresh Thanksgiving weather. While everybody should be inside enjoying their freshly made turkey or the freshly served ham and etc. The clouds are clear outside and the sun is shining bright with a little bit of chilliness because this Thanksgiving is giving us the high of 61 degrees and the low of 43 degrees. Are you thinking about heading to New York City's Macy's Parade this year? Well, while you are bringing yourself a mask, you better bring yourself a coat or just a tiny light jacket because there is going to be snows and snowflakes outside while you are watching the fun events for the Macy's Parade. Very exciting. Well, that's all I have for you this Thanksgiving, Faiss Flyers. I will catch you guys next week. Now on with my leaning.
And happy Thanksgiving. I'm Eileen. I'll be your sports reporter for this week. There is a special tradition on Thanksgiving that sports fans love and enjoy. This Thanksgiving, like many other Thanksgivings, there are three games. Every Thanksgiving, one of these three games is hosted by the Detroit Lions. They have hosted one of these three games since 1934. The Dallas Cowboys also have the same tradition as the Detroit Lions. The Cowboys started this tradition in 1966. Starting in 2006, a third game was added on to Thanksgiving. The first game of the day will be the Detroit Lions game. This year, the Detroit Lions will be playing the Houston Texans. They will be playing in Detroit in Ford Field and will be playing at 9:30 p.m. on CBS. The second game of the day will be the Dallas Cowboys game. The Washington football team will be going head-to-head with the Dallas Cowboys. The game will be at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. They will be playing at 1:30 p.m. and you can watch it on Fox. For this game, some lucky fans can watch the game in person, but there are limited tickets available. The last game of the day will be the Baltimore Ravens and the Pittsburgh Steelers. This should be a very interesting game because not only is it a divisional game, but also because the Steelers are undefeated. But will they even stay undefeated? Because the Ravens are no joke when it comes to football. They will be playing in Pittsburgh at Heinz Field at 5:20 p.m. and you can watch it on NBC. Like the Detroit Lions game, there will be limited tickets available, so there will be some fans in the stadium. Thanks for tuning in. This was the Thanksgiving special. Now.
Hey, Flyers, and welcome back to another edition of Fab 5 Thanksgiving Special Edition. This week I'm going to be talking about the top 5 foods you have on Thanksgiving and the pies. So let's get started. First is mashed potatoes, then stuffing, third is gravy, fourth is sweet potatoes, and fifth is rolls. Now onto the pies. The most popular is apple, of course. Next is pumpkin. Then strawberry. Fourth is cherry. And fifth is blueberry. That's it for this week. Make sure to stay tuned each week to learn more about your favorite people and things. Now on.
Hey there, Faiss Flyers, it's your proud principal, Mr. West. with some words of wisdom during Thanksgiving week. So first of all, I want to talk about some of the things I'm thankful for. And obviously this operation you see behind me is up there on the list high. Our food service workers have been here every day, Monday through Friday, from 7 a.m. to 1 p.m. to help make sure that you are fed and that you have the meals you need so that you can do distance ed to the best of your ability. A couple other things I'm thankful for. I'm thankful for organizations like Donors Choose that have picked our teachers and helped make their distance ed classrooms better. I'm thankful for everyone who participated in Pennies for Your Thoughts. We, as a school, were able to raise $965, just shy of our $1,000 goal, but still, given our circumstances, just absolutely outstanding. And then, very thankful for the Thunder Baseball organization. Typically, when we're in school, they use our fields. Some of you play for the Thunder organization, but they sponsored some of our families this year at Thanksgiving to make sure that they had a full Thanksgiving meal. So, very appreciative of that organization and that partnership with our school.
I am thankful for my education.
I'm thankful for my family, God, and my education.
Hello, this is Coach Derby, and I am thankful for my family, my friends, and good health. Stay safe. Bye.
I am thankful for my privilege.
I am thankful for my family.
Hi, it's Mr. and Mrs. Dalton, and we are thankful for our dog.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Hey there, Faiss Flyers, and now to my words of wisdom. As we draw closer to the Thanksgiving break, it's important that we think about the spirit behind this holiday. After all, Thanksgiving Day is just that, a day to give thanks. Great English novelist Charles Dickens says it this way: reflect upon your present blessings, of which every human has many, not on your past misfortunes, of which all have some. Between now and that great turkey feast, set aside your thoughts about everything that is wrong in our world and sad and depressing, and focus instead on what's good and right. And be especially grateful for the blessing of receiving an education, a blessing millions of children around the globe, unfortunately, will never receive. A good friend said it this way: happiness is not having what you want, it's wanting what you have. With something to think about, this is your proud principal, Mr. West. I want to take a moment to thank all of the people in my life that have made education so important, but also to the amazing staff here at Faiss Middle School, who every day work so hard to make sure that this distance education is as great as it can be, but know that we're gonna be back in these halls together again, hopefully soon, hopefully 2021. Make it a great day, or not, the choice is yours.
It means you're safer sitting here.
Okay.
Ah, the marshals! They'll corrupt your mind!